Good morning, everyone. We are gathered here for our student webinar series. Webinars built energy and momentum because they created a shared group experience. Coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is progress. Working together is success. The teacher, who is indeed wise, does not bid you to enter the house of his wisdom, but rather leads you to the threshold of our mind. Let me welcome our faculty coordinators, Dr. Shanti ma'am, Sampath Kumar sir, Niranjani ma'am, Saranya ma'am, Gayatri ma'am, and Pungadi ma'am, who always support and encourages us. Now, let me call upon Dr. S. Shanti, Assistant Professor, Department of CSE, to deliver the welcome address. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Shivani. A good morning to one and all. It gives me an immense pleasure in welcoming you all for this student webinar series. I am very much grateful to our management for giving us this opportunity for conducting student webinar series during this pandemic time. I am very much happy to welcome our resource persons, Ramya K, 3rd IT, and Kavipriya P, 3rd CSEB. They are going to give the webinar on career opportunities in public sector. I know that at the end of this webinar, you are all going to enrich the knowledge and possibilities of getting government jobs in public sector. Students, those who are not interested in getting placement in an IT company can try for these types of jobs. Definitely, this will be very helpful for you. Before we begin this webinar, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to all of you who sincerely committed to this event to make it a grand success. This would have been impossible without the support of each and everyone present here. Once again, I welcome you all for this student webinar series. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. It is a great pleasure for me to start with our student webinar series on the emerging topic, career opportunities in public sector. The UPSC aspirants can acquire tremendous knowledge in multiple dimensions while preparing for UPSC exams. The knowledge gained with the CSE preparations brings a totally new perspective towards life in whatever occupation we choose. UPSC Civil Service exam paves the way for becoming an IAS, IPS, IFS, IRS officer. The wide variety of jobs within the ambit of civil services offer greater sphere of authority and power than any other services in India. In banking sector, financial managers, bill and account collectors, bank tellers, loan officers, financial service representatives, bookkeeping and audit clerks, opportunities also available. We would like to hear a lot from our student speakers, Ramya K from 3rd IT and Kavipriya P from 3rd CSE on a powerful webinar series on career opportunities in public sector. Ramya K and Kavipriya P both are passionate to become a civil servant and serve our country. The best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others. They both got selected for RBI attendance exam. They are currently preparing for AFCAT exam. Now, I call upon Ramya K and Kavipriya P to start our webinar series.
Thank you, Shivani, for your wonderful introduction. Good morning, everyone. It feels great to be speaking with all of you today. So without any further delay, let's get into today's session. So the topic for the day is career opportunities in public sector. And it is going to be presented to you by myself. I am Ramya from 3rd IT. Along with me, Kavipriya from 3rd CSE has also joined with us. The agenda for the day is, initially, we'll be giving you some introduction about the session. Next, I will be presenting you the opportunities in civil services. The rest, bank exams, insurance exams, and other exams will be discussed by Kavipriya. I hope after this session, you'll get to know more about this field. So let's get started. First of all, I would like to refresh one thing to all of you. That is, there is some difference between job and career, which most of you know, right? I'll tell you the difference in short today. A job is something like a regular employment, which you can do either full-time or part-time just for earning money. But career is something like a profession which requires specific training, specific skills, which you can take it as a life work. Your passion and sense of fulfillment drives you through your career. You have got many career like teaching, doctors, engineers, architect, artist, etc. and etc. Along with this, we have got one most sought after career in our country, that is nothing but the career in public sector, which gives you greater sphere of authority and power. More than anything, you'll get an opportunity to serve your country, right? It's like an opportunity where you can change your society, change your country. It is like, there is a saying by Mahatma Gandhi, I think everyone would have heard that, be the change you want to see in the world. I think this suits this career very well. So if you want to see some change in the world or in the country, you can choose this career. Next, I would like to share with you some advantages if you become a public servant. If you are a public servant, the first thing, you can make difference in the society. As I said earlier, you can make difference in our society. You may be the change which your society wants. Second comes the job security. Most of the public servants enjoy greater job security. Like they can be they cannot be dismissed from their service without any inquiry, or even they will also be given a chance to defend themselves in such a situation. And next comes the flexibility. Flexibility in the sense you will get a flexible working hours with a proper break and proper time off. And next comes the post-retirement benefits. I think this most of you all know, right? You'll get a pension after retirement if you are a public servant. Then you can be appointed to various commissions and other tribunals of our government. For example, if you are an IAS officer, you'll be sought after by many, even many private companies will also be calling you because of your talents. So there are so many advantages of being a public servant. I have mentioned only few, but there are so many advantages of being a public servant. Having said that, let's jump into the most important part of my session, that is the civil services, opportunities in civil services. Before moving into the post available in civil services, I would like to refresh one thing. Civil service examination is one of the most prestigious examinations of India. It is conducted by Union Public Service Commission, and it is one of the toughest exams in the country. You can say it as the mother of all written examinations in our country. In spite of all popularity of software engineers and IT careers nowadays, UPSC has not lost its value yet. Civil service is very important for any country. Like, it forms the backbone of the Indian government, except those elected representatives like MLAs, MPs, all others are from civil services, right? So it is the primary service which hits all the major departments which run the state and central administration. Out of lakhs of aspirants appearing for UPSC, only a few thousand dedicated students can successfully clear this exam. Yeah, it is tough, but with proper planning and proper guidance and preparation, you can crack any kind of examinations, right? For example, I'll give you approximate statistics. In 2018, 10,65,552 candidates applied for UPSC. Out of them, only 5,484 candidates took prelims. Here itself, 5 lakhs went out of the competition. In that 5 lakhs who appeared for prelims, only 10,419 cleared prelims. 10,246 students appeared for mains. In that 10,246, 2,000 made to clear mains in the interview. As I was saying, out of 2,000 appeared for interview, only 1,000 made to clear that interview and get posting. So out of 10 lakhs, only 1,000 can crack the exam. Out of all those 10 lakhs, only 25 to 30% of students will be fully prepared. Rest are like trial and error. They will be just giving a try. So you need not bother about them. The competition will be between those 25 to 30% of students. If you are planned properly, then you can be in that 30% and you can also crack that exam as well. So the proper planning and preparation is very important when UPSC is concerned. So the allotment of services to successful candidates depends upon the ranking you have got in the exam. For example, if you have got the higher rank, then you can get your cadre of your choice. The higher your rank, more the chance to get cadre of your choice. So your aim should be to score more marks. Having said that, next I'll take you through the postings available in civil services and their respective roles. UPSC exams provide 24 different civil services under one exam, that is the civil service examination, which is conducted by our Union Public Service Commission. Those 24 different civil services has been majorly classified into three types: All India Civil Services, Group A Civil Services, and Group B Civil Services. For the All India Civil Services. In All India Civil Services, the first comes the Indian Administrative Service, as we all know, that is the IAS posting. It is the permanent arm of Government of India and state governments. It is responsible for formulating and implementing government policies. Initially, if you are selected for IAS cadre, then you will be posted as sub-divisional magistrate or under-secretary in our state secretariat or sub-collector. Your starting basic pay will be 56,100 Indian rupees. So, next comes the Indian Police Service, IPS officers. IPS officers can occupy senior positions in investigation bureaus, Central Bureau of Investigation. Initially, you will be posted as DSP, but after that, you can be in senior positions. Your basic pay will be 56,100 Indian rupees. Next comes the Indian Forest Service. The highest posting available in Indian Forest Service is Director General of Forest. Also, you can get to work at numerous government organizations like food and agricultural organizations. Initially, you will be posted as a forest range officer where the salary is 60,000 rupees Indian rupees. The vacancies available in Indian Forest Service is less when compared to IAS and IPS officers. Approximately 30 to 40 candidates will be posted under Indian Forest Service. Next, let's move into Group A Civil Services. In Group A Civil Services, first comes the Indian Foreign Service. If you are selected under IFS cadre, then the responsibility for you is to handle foreign affairs of India. You can be posted in as High Commissioner or Ambassador of India or Permanent Representative of India at multilateral institutions like United Nations. Mostly, you will be working in Indian embassies. Next posting is Indian Audit and Account Service. The responsibility of this cadre is the financial auditing of central government, state government, and other public sector undertakings. Next job is Indian Civil Account Service. In this, the responsibility is to frame and optimize the manuals. You'll be framing rules and procedures for accounting of receipts and payments. Currently, there are 9,000 employees and 226 officers working under this cadre. Next comes the Indian Corporate Law Service. The main responsibility of this cadre is to ensure that all companies in India are filing their annual returns and balance sheets and all other documents properly. You have to verify whether they are doing it properly or not. Next comes the Indian Defense Account Service. The main responsibility of this cadre is to provide financial advice or internal auditing and accounting functions of the Army Forces, Army, Air Force, Navy, DRDO, and other allied organizations, defense-related organizations. So you will also be sent to overseas as a representative of Indian Army, like like UN peacekeeping missions. Next comes Indian Defense Estate Service. The main responsibility of this service is to manage and administer the civil services of defense lands in our country. They will conduct survey of defense lands available in our country. Next comes the Indian Information Service. It is the main media wing of our government of India. It forms the bridge between the public and the government. If you are selected under this cadre, you can be posted as officers in PIB, All India Radio, Doordarshan, and all those media related organizations. Next comes Indian Ordnance Factory Service. Ordnance is nothing but the military related materials. All those will be called as ordnance. So in this cadre, you will be managing the ordnance factories of our Indian Army. So that is the main role available in this cadre. Next comes the Indian Communication Finance Service. In this, the main responsibility is to account and financial services to Indian Post and Telecommunication. You will be accounting the finances in postal service and telecommunication service. Next comes the Indian Postal Service. It is responsible for running Indian Post, which is the largest postal network in the world. It provides services ranging from traditional postal services to banking and even e-commerce services. Next comes the Indian Railway Account Service. It is responsible for maintaining accounts in the railways. Next is the Indian Railway Personnel Service. It is related to maintenance of human resources in our Indian railways. Next is Indian Railway Traffic Service. It is responsible for managing transportation of Indian railways. It is also responsible for revenue collection. You will be posted as officers under this cadre. Next comes the Indian Revenue Service. It is concerned with revenue collections in India. You will be responsible for implementing direct and indirect taxes. You can get a job in income tax office. Every state has an income tax office, so you'll get a job there. Next is Indian Trade Service. If you are selected under this cadre, your responsibility is to implement the provisions of foreign trade. You will be formulating the policies related to internal trade. You'll be taking steps to promote or export. Next is Railway Protection Force. It is like a police force in railways. They are responsible for protecting property and passengers of Indian railways. So all these 16 cadres are available under Group A Civil Services. Next comes the Group B Civil Services. The first one in Group B Civil Services is Armed Force Headquarters Civil Services. It is basically for all the armed forces in our country. That is to provide basic support services to Indian Armed Force and inter-services organizations. Next is the DANICS and DANIPS. The full form of this is Delhi, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Lakshadweep, Daman and Diu, Dadra, Nagar Haveli, Civil Service and Police Service. Like every state, our union territories are also provided with civil service and police service facilities. Next comes the Pondicherry Civil Service and Pondicherry Police Service. Like other union territories, Pondicherry is also provided with civil service and police service. Now, I'll take you through the selection process step by step. First one, you have to apply for prelims. If you clear prelims, then you will be called for mains. In mains, out of 7 exams, if you are passed in all exams, you have cleared all the cutoffs in all the 7 exams, then you will be called for interview. If you clear interview, then you will be given training. Let me tell you the pattern in detail. For prelims, you will be writing 2 papers. First one is CSAT and General Studies paper. CSAT is Civil Service Aptitude Test, where you will be given general English aptitude and reasoning. It is to test your analytical skills. It will be conducted for 200 marks. And next paper is General Studies. It is also conducted for 200 marks. Both are MCQ type of questions. You have to clear the sectional cutoff they are providing. Only then you can get into mains. If you clear prelims, then you will be called for mains. In mains, there are 7 papers. First paper is English essay writing. Next 4 papers is general studies paper, which covers history, geography, biodiversity, science and technology, ethics, international relations, current affairs in different papers. The last 2 is optional papers. Among the optional papers available, you have to choose 2 of your preference and you have to appear for that exam. If you clear all these 7 exams, then you will be called for interview. In you'll be writing each paper 50 marks. Totally, you'll be writing for 1,750 marks. In that, if you are passed, then you'll be called for interview, which is conducted for 275 marks. It is to test your personality, your attitude, how you react. They won't look for answers. They will look for your response, how you are reacting to your question. That is very important, more than answering. So next, I'll tell you the eligibility criteria. First of all, nationality is very important. If you are looking for All India Civil Services, then you must be a citizen of India. If you are looking for Group A or Group B Civil Services, you must be a citizen of India, or else you can be a citizen from Nepal or Bhutan. These 2 will be available for you. Next is the educational qualification. You must hold a graduate degree from a recognized university in our country. So that is required. A graduation is required for UPSC. Next is UPSC age limit. The lower relaxation, that is, you must be 21 years of age if you want to appear for UPSC. And the upper relaxation depends upon the section you belong to. So I'll tell you the upper relaxations for different sections. If you are under general category, your upper relaxation will be 32. And the number of attempts given to you will be only 6. If you are under OBC category, your upper relaxation is 35 and you will be given 9 attempts. If you are under SC or ST category, upper relaxation is 37. And within 37, you can give unlimited attempts. Next, if you are a disabled defense service personnel, your upper relaxation is 35 and you can give 9 number of attempts. If you are ex-serviceman, then your upper relaxation is 37 and you can give 9 attempts. If you are a person with benchmark disability, then your upper relaxation is 42 and you can give 9 attempts as well. So I hope everyone would have understood the pattern, the post, the criteria required for a UPSC aspirant. Now I'll tell you the qualities you must acquire if you want to get into UPSC. First thing is honesty. You should be honest to yourself first. This is the one quality that you cannot ignore if you want to serve the people and solve their problems. So honesty and patriotism. You should be patriotic towards your country. That is very important. Next comes the leadership skills. You are going to administer one state or one commission. So you must be very good at your leadership skills. A leader should be committed to his work. He should be confident, should be brave enough. In short, I can tell a leader is one who knows the way, who goes the way and shows the way. So you must be such a leader. Only then you can get into UPSC. Next comes the communication skills. Communication is again an important trait that will not only help you as a UPSC aspirant, but in general, in any walks of life, it is very important. If you have got good communication skills, you can reach heights. It is important to let the people know your vision and convey exactly what you expect out of them. So that is very important. It can be achieved only if you have a good communication skills. Next comes the hard work and concentration. Success never comes easily. So you have to work for it really hard with proper concentration on your passion. So that is hard work and concentration. Next is out of the box thinking and decisive in approach. You should not be in dilemma while you are preparing. Even if you become an officer, you should not be in dilemma. You should know how to take decision in every situation. Sometimes you have to think out of the box also. Next is analytical skills and knowledge. Your analytical skills will be tested right from the beginning. That is from prelims till your personality test, your analytical skills will be tested. they'll be testing how you react or how you respond to any situation and your knowledge. Without any doubt, you must have knowledge to clear UPSC examinations. So all these qualities are required if you want to clear UPSC exam. Even after clearing UPSC exam, all these qualities are required to survive and to serve your people. So before handing it over to Kavipriya, I just want to complete it with a quote. If you don't make the time to work on creating a life you want, you are eventually going to be forced to spend a lot of time dealing with the life you don't want. It's very true, right? So spend each and every second wisely and develop your career properly. It is not only in public sector career, in whatever career you choose, you should spend your time for that. Only then you can develop it and you can lead your life successfully. So thank you so much. Over to you, Kavipriya.
Thank you, Ramya. Once again, I welcome you all for the webinar. I think everyone got idea about UPSC exams, and here I am share about opportunities in bank, insurance and other sectors. So here I like to start with one quote. It's nothing but if you think you can, you can. If you fix a goal and you have confidence in that, surely you can achieve that goal. So let's enter into a topic. It's about bank. Here we have SBI. SBI means State Bank of India. They're conducting nearly three exams. So SO, PO and clerical. SO means specialist officer. PO is a probationary officer. So in SO, there is a 7+ post like manager and deputy manager. According to your age and experience, the post will be allocated to you. So already the notification for this year has been released with 452 vacancies. Next, if we move on to SBI PO, in SBI PO, if you are selected as a candidate in that bank, so after 2 years, you will get a promotion. It may be an assistant manager or deputy manager. Then you have a manager post like this we have. So here chairman is the highest post. In SBI clerical, we have a 5,000+ vacancies has been released for this year. And other than this, in IBBS, RRB, scale 1 officer and office assistants exam has been released with a 9,000+ vacancies. We have IBBS, SO, PO and clerical exams also. RBI grade B officer and assistants, postal banks and private banks. Nearly this year we get 8+ exams in a bank. So let's move on to our insurance sector. In insurance, we have administrative officer, assistant administrative officer, development officer, apprentice development officer, and assistants. So not only in a bank, we also have opportunities in insurance also. Other than insurance, we have more exams. We will see later. So let's enter into the selection process. How they are selecting the candidate for bank exams? There are three exams. One's a prelims, mains, interview. Prelims is nothing but it's a gateway for everyone. If you clear prelims, you can enter into the mains. If you clear mains, you can enter into the interview. In some exams, we don't have an interview. For example, in a clerical, we have only prelims and mains. We don't have an interview. It depends upon the exam you're going to appear. Let's see the prelims pattern, the following. It's a common pattern, but according to exam, your appearing will be changed. The mark and timings will be changed according to the exams you are going to appear. But we have a common thing here. In a prelims pattern, they will ask the aptitude, reasoning, current affairs, and English. If you see here, there will be a three thing. One is the overall cutoff, sectional cutoff, and negative mark. Negative mark will differ. It may be a 0.25 or 0.5. So in an overall cutoff means, if you are appearing for 120 mark, so overall cutoff may be 80 or 90. You have to score above that. You have to clear that overall cutoff. And sectional cutoff is nothing but if you take aptitude, if they ask the aptitude for 40 marks, you they fix as a 30 or 28 as a sectional cutoff. You have to clear that. So if you clear a sectional cutoff and overall cutoff, you can eligible for mains. The same pattern they have been following in a mains also. There is a some difference is the level of questions only difference in a bank exam. Let's be enter into the mains pattern. In mains also same. And I have to mention one more thing. So in a prelims we don't have a current affairs. So and in if you enter into the mains, so in a mains we have a aptitude, reasoning, current affairs, English, and descriptive. Here the descriptive paper is add-on. Some exams in if you take a RRB scale one officer, we don't have a descriptive paper. Instead, we have a computer knowledge. They ask the question in a later to computer. Next, if you in aptitude, they will ask a number series, simplifications, both and seen, data interpretation like that we have. In the reasoning, we have seating arrangement, directions, blood relations, ranking, inequalities that like we have. So if you take current affairs, they will ask past 3 to 4 months. Here the sectional timing, we have a sectional timing. They allocated a sectional timing. If you take aptitude, they have a 20 to 30 minutes as a time. You have to complete within that time aptitude. So it's a one big thing here. And we have on a big task here that is nothing but time management and presence of mind. Because why I'm saying here is time management, you have to in a 20 to 25 minutes you have to attend 30 to 35 questions. So time management plays a very important role here, and a presence of mind also plays a very important role, because in a 20 minutes you have to attend 30 to 35 questions. The questions will be easy, you have to click the logic at the time. So it's also a very big task here. I like to share one more point here. It's nothing but I read this in one book. If you choose a goal, if you're passionate to that and you are confident in this, you can achieve that. Your mind will show the n number of ways to achieve that goal. So it's on if you are passionate and if you are confident in that, surely your mind will give a n number of ways. So okay, let's enter into the eligibility criteria. Eligibility criteria will differ for exam to exam. Some exams have 20 or 19 as a eligibility. Some exams, most of the exams have 21. So you can appear up to 30 or 32. It's differ for exam to exams. Here they are following a common pattern, but according to the exam you are appearing, the pattern will be changed. For example, sometimes you have a 40 aptitude question, 30 reasoning question like that. So pattern is same, but according to the exam it will be different. So let's enter into the bank job salaries. So in this, I'm saying about a basic salary they are providing for you. In a probationary officer, they are providing a 58,000 plus. In clerical cadre, they are providing 19,000 to 31,000. In scale one officer, they are providing 29,000 to 33,000. In office assistants, they are providing 15,000 to 20,000. In RBI grade B officer, they are providing 77,000 plus. In assistants, they are providing 36,000. It's a, I'm saying about a basic pay, not it is the highest pay. And we are moving to the insurance. In insurance, we have administrative officer, they're paying 62,000 plus. And assistant administrative officer, they are providing a 32,000 plus. In development officer, they're providing a 48,000 plus. In apprentice development, they are providing a 21,000 plus. Other exams we have are TNPCs, ISRO, SSC, intelligence bureau, AppsCat, like that we have. In ISTO assistance, they are providing a 34,000 plus. In IB assistance, they are providing a 34,000 plus. So qualities like that. So what are the qualities they are expecting that? So communication skill is the main thing. If you have a good communication skill, you can able to crack the interview. Problem solving skill. In a problem solving, if they give us problem for you, how you are approaching, how you are solving, how you are showing the uniqueness, it's all under the problem solving. Teamwork. In a teamwork, if you are in a team, how you are showing your interest, responsibilities, honesty, activeness, all included in a teamwork. Leadership. In a leadership, if you are managing a team or if you work as a leader for a team, so you have a confidence, courage, self-confidence, self-development, and how you are encouraging your team, all included in a leadership. Organization and team management. So if you organize an event, surely you can have difficult situation or stressful situation there. So you, how you are approaching the situation, how you are positively taken the situation, how you are moving on is all in an organization. So customer service, in a customer service, how you are answering the questions for customers, how you are answering for the, how you are answering the customer, and how you are paying respect, how is your communications, it's all plays a major role in a organization. Next, here I like to share about our college alumni. She was a 2020 passed out. Now she got placed in a BOI, Bank of India, and she is a Ms. Surya. She cleared a SBA clerical, IBBS PO prelims, IBBS RRB office assistance prelims, and she. And I like to conclude with this, with the last quote. It's nothing but, don't burn your opportunities for temporary comfort zone. Here we have a more opportunities. If you think it is hard, or I can't able to accept, or if you think in this field, I can't able to enjoy my life, if you think in that aspect, you are losing opportunities in your hand. We can't get these opportunities after 30 or 32 age. So please focus on your career, not on a job. I hope everyone got an idea about UPSC and bank exams. What are the opportunities we have? So finally, if you have any queries, you can post.
Thank you, Ramya and Kavipriya. Dear participants, you can post your queries in chat box. Dear Ramya and Kavipriya, any suggestion for choosing UPSC study group?
Okay, actually, I'm not clear with the question, what they're asking UPSC study group, but I want to tell one thing here. Our college itself providing coaching by tying up with five national award winning institutions in Coimbatore, ZBank, IRO. So I think they are asking like institutions. So that's my answer.
Thank you, Ramya. All participants are requested to provide your valuable feedback through the link given in the chat box. Now I request Mr. Sampath Kumar sir, Assistant Professor, Department of CSE, to give a virtual certificate.
Okay, thank you, Shivani. Thank you, Ramya and Kavipriya.
Sir.
It was a wonderful session.
Sir.
Yes, Kavipriya.
Sir, one second, sir. Thank you so much,
sir.
Okay, sir. First, I thank Shishu College of Engineering for providing such wonderful opportunities here. And I thank Sampath sir and Nilanshi ma'am for support. And I finally thank ZBanker Balasindra Kumar sir for preparing a PPT for us. And I thank Danush for helping a promo video for us. And I thank everyone, each and everyone present here, and thank you.
Thank you, Kavi Priya. Hope my screen is visible to you. First of all, I thank Shivani for doing a wonderful MOC, for managing all this session, Then I thank Kavi Priya and Ramya for the wonderful presentation on career opportunities in public sector. Thank you, both of you. Now we are moving to the last session. So vote of thanks. I hope all of you have got a good idea about the public sector, because most of us are preferring private jobs, but it is not a wrong one, but there are many opportunities in public sector which we are not using it. Okay, so if you see the total number of students getting into public sector from South India, especially from Tamil Nadu, it is very low. The reason behind that is they don't have much awareness. Okay, so I hope many of you got a good awareness about openings in public sector, that especially in banking sector and in administration sector. I hope all of you got a good idea about it, and thank you very much for joining today's session. And next week we can join again in another wonderful session. Thank you again.
இங்கேதான் அன்பு கிடைத்தது, பண்பு கிடைத்தது, நட்பு கிடைத்தது, கனவு கிடைத்தது, நம்மீஸ்வர் கல்லூரி. இங்கேதான் தெளிவு கிடைத்தது, அறிவு கிடைத்தது, அறமும் கிடைத்தது, அனைத்தும் கிடைத்தது, நம்மீஸ்வர் கல்லூரி. பசுமை வண்ணம் கொண்ட சூழலிலே மயில்கள் கொண்ட என் கல்லூரியே, ஒற்றுமைக்கும் உத்வேகம் ஆசிரியர்கள் எல்லோரும் வெற்றிகளின் அஸ்திவாரம். ஆதவன் இல்லாமல் விடியல் ஏது, பாதைகள் இல்லாமல் பயணம் ஏது, கேள்விகள் இல்லாமல் விடைகள் ஏது, ஈஸ்வர் கல்லூரி இல்லாமல் இன்பம் ஏது. அங்கே உலகம் கற்றுக்கொள்வோமே, நம் காலேஜின் பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் அது என்றும் சூப்பர், அங்கே வேலையும் பெற்றுக்கொள்வோமே. நான்காண்டுகளே என்றாலும் ஒரு குடும்பம் போல வாழ்ந்திடுவோம், 40 ஆண்டுகள் கடந்த பின்னும் நம் கல்லூரி நாட்களை போற்றிடுவோம். இந்த நிலையை நாங்கள் அடைந்தாலும், வாழ்வில் உயர பறந்தாலும், மறவோம் மறவோம் ஒரு நாளும் நாங்கள் ஈஸ்வரில் பயின்ற நாட்களை. ஈஸ்வர் கல்லூரி வாழ்க்கை கற்று தந்த பாடம், காலம் எல்லாம் கண்ணில் நிழலாடும். ஆதவன் இல்லாமல் வெடிகள் ஏது, பாதைகள் இல்லாமல் பயணம் ஏது, கேள்விகள் இல்லாமல் விடைகள் ஏது, ஈஸ்வர்
Okay, thank you very much for joining, dear students. Have a nice day. Please stay home and stay safe.